Okay, let's run a couple of other commands and we'll call it a day, and then I want you to practice some of the things that I've shown you here so that you become acquainted with all the commands that we've run thus far. Okay, notice that we ran this, and oh, there's so many files in here, and it ran off the screen, right? It ran all the way off the screen. It's like a screen and a half's worth of information. Well, if you're over here, and let me just use this in server because I know we're not using server, but I'll show you what this means. Let's go ahead here. Remember, we're in home, and you can do this in your Mint. So let's cd back to our home directory. How do we do that? Remember, home, we type ls here. Remember, PC is our home directory. So we can type cd PC, right? And we're in our home directory. If you would like the full, notice that this is just as in Windows, and this, for some reason, this confuses a lot of students, but there's something called a path in any operating system, and a path just shows you where you are in the directory structure. And so right now we're not exactly sure, but it looks like we know we're in our home directory, and our home directory is under the home directory, which holds everybody's individual account information. If we ever want to know specifically the absolute path where we currently reside, we type pwd for present working directory. This says we're in home PC. Hey, that's good to know. Let's jump back over here to Mint. Let's hit enter to go back here. Present working directory, home PC. So we know the absolute path where we are. What's the absolute path back here in Windows? C users Craig EP. That's the absolute path. Here we are, home PC. That's the absolute path. Now, you know what? I don't want to see any of this on screen anymore. I want to get rid of it. How do I do that? Do you remember how to do that in Windows? CLS. And that clears your screen. In Linux and in all Unix, clear. So that clears your screen. Okay, two more things before we call it a day. Remember when we ran this, ls-al, and it scrolled off the screen? So we have to go over here and scroll back up here. Well, you know what? If you're in here and you type in ls-al, and of course there's fewer configuration files in the server version, as you will see. But if this was one, two, or three screens long, which it very may well be, if you've added a number of different applications under server, is that you can't scroll back up. You know why? Because there's no scroll bar. There is no scroll bar. So, well, how would you go about finding what's showing here if it all scrolls off the screen like this? And this is where, recall, ls-al is that I showed you this, let's scream back over here, this pipe command, the pipe. The pipe says, hey, take everything that's over here and shove it into this command. Now, we don't want to do that right here. We don't want to run this command, but we'll run another command that will allow you to freely scroll up and down through this whole list of things. So let's run the pipe. And we're going to be using another command called less, L-E-S-S. And less is a pager, and it allows you to scroll up and down through either a directory listing or a very long file. And so if we type ls-al, send the contents of this to less, we're already chaining together commands, and it's just your first 34 minutes of Linux. Isn't that awesome? So let's hit enter. Boom. What does it show us? It shows us the top of the command, or the top, excuse me, the results of the very... shows us the top of the results. And so we can see everything that we saw previously. The only downside to this is it's not colored in blue, but you know what? You should be able to tell what these are, whether they are a file, like right here and here, because it doesn't have the D, And this is a directory. Now, recall, and this should work very similar in Windows, but if we hit the space bar, we scroll down to the next page. So we've scrolled down to the next page all the way to the end, and notice that we know it's at the end because it says end. If this were, let's say, 10 screens of information, it wouldn't say end at the bottom, but it would show you, again, if you saw earlier, that there was a colon down here indicating there's still more stuff to be displayed. So how do we get out of this? Well, it doesn't say, but recall with the man page, if you hit Q, it gets you out and takes you back to the command line. And what if I wanted to run this again? In fact, let's make this a little more difficult. Here's the templates. Let's go to the videos directory. How do we go to the videos directory? CD space. Now, if you're a Linux noob, you're going to type V-I-D-E-O-S. God, don't do that. Type V, tab. It auto-completes. It saves you thousands of characters of typing a day. Videos. Where are we? We're in the videos directory. PWD, what's our present working directory? Home, PC, videos. Now let's type ls-al and pipe it to less. No, don't do that. Use the up arrow keys. Boom. Done. You see how quickly I did that? Instead of typing all that, the ls-al, all I had to do was hit the up arrow key a couple of times and hit enter. Notice that the only things that we have here in the videos directory are two directories. What are those directories? The current directory and the parent directory. How do we get out of this? Hit Q. Whoops, I accidentally hit the two. That was my bad. And we're back to the videos directory. What if I want to go back to the PC directory, the parent directory? What do I do? Well, and this is up to you. You could either scroll back up through here and find it, and sometimes it's just quicker to type CD space dot dot parent directory. What directory am I in? PC. Okay, one more very important piece of information. This is something that you'll forget because Windows allows you to shoot yourself in the foot all day long if you want to when it comes to typing out the command, because Windows is not case sensitive. Linux is case sensitive. And what that means is that notice that I typed ls. Notice that I didn't type capital L small s, or I didn't type small l capital s. Yep, there we are. Is that I type little l little s. All commands in Linux will be in small case. It is case sensitive. Let's say for accidentally I hit the caps lock and I typed ls and I hit enter. Whoa, that kind of looks like an error, right? The program ls is currently not installed. Oh gosh, I don't know. Let me type cd dot dot. Command not found. Oh, now I'm really panicking. Command not found. Take off the caps lock. And there we are. Okay, one more thing I want to show you for practice is to see a little more of the directory structure. What I want you to do is to type CD space and the forward slash. Okay, notice where we are, the forward slash. Present working directory is just a forward slash. The forward slash is called the root directory. If we go back here, and let's do, hey, wait a second, those dot dots worked in Windows. I bet you never knew that, did you? This is the root directory. C colon backslash is the root directory for Windows. Well, analogously, the root directory for Linux is the forward slash. Let's type ls-al, and you could have used the arrow keys to get there. Well, let's see what's all in there. Oh, lots of good stuff. So we can use the arrow keys to go up and down. see what's going on. Okay, and so what I want you to do is I want you to navigate around the Linux system. Go into some of these directories. See what's in there. So CD to the directory. See what's in there. Keep on going down. Go down as far as you can. For example, let's type Q to quit. There was something called a VAR directory. VA tab. Let's type, go back up and type ls-al. Here's some more directories. Here's one called mail. Okay, so we're in the var directory. Let's scroll back up to our commands. Okay, and we've got, here's the mail directory. Let's hit Q, cdma tab. There's the mail directory. Arrow back up. Oh, there's nothing else in there. Shoot, so we're kind of at a dead end. Let's hit Q to get out of there. What's our present working directory? Var mail. So see that first forward slash? That's your root directory. Okay, let's go up to the parent directory. And let's rerun ls-al. Let's see if we can go further down in here. Opt. Let's see if there's anything in opt right here. Q to get out. CDOP tab. And that's our directory. Arrow key back up. Ah, we're at the end. Okay. Well, what I wanted to show you is there's a really quick and simple way to get back to your home directory. Now, remember that the home directory was symbolized by the tilde key, right? So what if we just did CD tilde? Let's see what happens. Well, it looks like I'm back in my home directory, and I am. Awesome. Okay, that ends this lesson. You've learned quite a bit already. You should have been following along. If you haven't been following along and running the video and pausing it and running what I've done, shame on you, because you're not going to do well in the assignments, and I can't just give a grade. You have to earn your grade. And this will be extremely important because, you know what? Everybody knows Windows. Everybody goes through and gets a certificate for Windows, which means you are not going to stand out when it comes time to get a job. However, if you get good at Linux, I promise you. Remember I said Google and Twitter and Facebook and even Microsoft, yep, they sure do. They use Linux servers, at least in some small capacity. So you make yourself stand out by getting good at Linux, knowing it backwards and forwards, and putting that on your resume.